हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इंग्लिश सेशन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर न्यू लेसन यूनिट 4, द पोर्ट्रेट ऑफ अ लेडी। एंड ऑथर ऑफ दिस लेसन इज खुशवंत सिंह। सो लेट्स वी सी अबाउट खुशवंत सिंह। खुशवंत सिंह इज इंडियन राइटर इन इंग्लिश। ही वॉज बॉर्न ऑन 2 फरवरी 1940। He is a prominent Indian novelist and journalist. Singh's weekly column with Malak Towards One and All, carried by several Indian newspapers, is among the most widely read column in the country. Singh is the best for his penchant for secularism, his humor, and his abiding love of poetry. He got so many awards like Padma Bhushan in 1974 and Padma Vibhushan in 2007. He was one of the editor of famed Illustrated Weekly of India. His work includes a history of Sikh train to Pakistan, Delhi and etc. So let's read the glossary loudly. As I always say, you have to read the glossary loudly. In this story, the author draws a pen portrait of his grandmother. He beautifully unfolds his relationship with her while describing her appearance, that is looking, and daily activities which he spent with her. So this story is about an author's grandmother and sweet memories which spent by author with her grandmother. And all he writes that how she looks, what the activity she used to do, everything is written in this particular chapter. So let's see the chapter. In first paragraph, the author says that his grandmother was like everyone's grandmother. She was an old lady, okay? And she was very old, that we can see a wrinkle on her face. And he remember about 20 years he know her with the wrinkle as she was old. And he heard the stories about his grandmother. People used to say that when she was young she was very much beautiful and even she was very much pretty, okay? But for the author it was very difficult to believe, because the author have seen her when she was old, right? When she was old, or when she had a wrinkle on her face, that time he remember. And it was very hard for the author to digest that my grandmother was, when she was young, she was very pretty, okay? And the author never seen his grandfather, but he saw a photo which was hung in a room, okay? And he described how my grandfather was, or in that photo how he was looking. So he wore a big turban, he was wearing a loose fitting cloth, and he had a very white beard, and he was very healthy, and he was around 100 years old in that particular photo. So here author remember that his grandmother used to tell what different kinds of games she used to play when she was a child, okay? And she always tells stories like fables or prophets or scriptures about God. So she always remember that my grandmother used to tell us stories, and even our grandmother tells us stories, and the stories related to God. So he tells that my grandmother used to be like this. So in second paragraph, the author described exact description of how his grandmother was looking. So he says she was short, she was fat, and she was slightly bent. Her spinal cord become weak, so she was bent. Okay, and all on her face it was a crisscross of wrinkles running everywhere. And he know her only when she was old. Okay, he would know his grandmother when she was old. Okay, and as the days was passing, the author only see her getting old by day by day. So she was growing older day by day, and she was pretty, okay? She can be a pretty, but she was always beautiful. So he can't know that my grandmother was pretty, but he always believed that his grandmother was always beautiful. Okay, and she used to keep one hand on her waist for support, and one hand was always busy with a rosary. The rosary was chanting, okay, and her lips were never stopped. She'll be keep on telling the God name, or it continuously moves. Her lips will continuously move in the inaudible prayer. That means we cannot hear the prayer, but always she used to say something, right? And he says, yes, my grandmother was very much beautiful, and I feel she was pure, a white serenity. And whenever the author sees his grandmother, he always feel a peace. He always feel the peace being with his grandmother. So let's see the initial years of Kripayadana's life in the village. So how the author and his grandmother were living in the village. So in the paragraph 3, he says that both the author and the grandmother were very good friends. Now the question is, why the author was staying with the grandmother? His parents left him with her grandmother, with his grandmother, because author's parents went to live in city, okay? And they wanted to settle down there. So until they get settled there, they left the author to the grandmother, okay? And now, every morning, what a grandmother used to do, grandmother used to wake up him and she used to make him ready for the school, okay? And when she is making him bath or making him ready, she used to sing the monotonous sing song, that is a God's song, okay? She used to sing a song and she used to dress him, she used to make him ready, so that what will happen, author may listen that song and it can by heart, it can be by heart by the author, okay? And but here the author used to listen the song not to by heart, but because he was in love with her voice, he was in love with her grandmother's voice, okay? And now here what happened next, what happened, she used to make it ready, the slate, you know, you know the slate, right, where you write on the chalk piece, with a chalk piece. So he had a one wooden slate, and she used to give a chalk, a tiny earthen ink pot with a red pen. She used to tie with a bundle, and she used to hand over to the author. Okay, now what was there for the breakfast? The breakfast was a thick stale chapati, okay, with a little butter and a sugar spread on it. Okay, and they both went to the school, and she also carried some stale chapatis. Maybe for night leftover chapatis to feed the village dogs. In paragraph 4, he says, the author says, that his grandmother was always used to go to school with him. Why she always used to go to school with him? Because the school was attached to the temple. So next to the school, there was a temple. Okay. And in that school, the priest used to teach the alphabets and the morning prayer. Okay. So now he's describing how the school was. So the children used to sit in a row. Okay. Either side, in the side of the veranda, that is sitting in the veranda and singing the alphabet or the song or the prayer in the chorus, okay? And his grandmother used to sit inside the temple, and she used to be busy with reading the scripture, okay? So once they both have finished the work, that is the author finished his school, and once the grandmother finished her reading the scripture book, they used to go together, and there was a time where she used to meet the dog in the temple door, okay? And all the time, this what used to do mother grandmother, she used to give the chapatis to the dogs, right? And they used to she used to throw some chapatis for all the dogs, and that is how she used to be very helping towards the dog. So she was very humble, and she was very kind towards the dog also. So she used to get chapatis, stale chapatis for the dogs. Now let's see the turning point of their friendship, that is life in the city. So in paragraph 5, the author says, when his parents were comfortably settled in a city, okay, now they sent for us. That means they called us, okay? And that is where the friendship between the grandmother and the son, grandson, had been changed. Now, what changes they can see or what changes they have felt? They felt that they were not sharing the same room. The first difference. Second, the grandmother no longer used to come to school with him, okay? As he used to go to the English school, of course, right? In a city, you have a English school, right? We can hardly see a school attached with a temple. So here, he used to go to an English school, and that school, he used to go in a school bus. Of course, he has to go in a school bus. And then, even he noticed that there were no dogs in the streets. So what his grandmother did? So in her boredom time, in her bored time, she started feeding the sparrow, which used to come in her courtyard. Courtyard is nothing but the veranda, okay? So she used to feed the sparrows in the veranda. In paragraph 6, the author says, as the days was going, as the years were going, they were not connecting to each other. They were not meeting each other. They are not seeing each other. Okay. And sometimes what happened? Sometimes she used to make him wake up him. She used to try to make him ready for the school. Okay. And when he used to come back from the school, she used to ask, what teacher taught you in the school? But he used to tell the English words and the little things about Western science or law of gravity, different kinds of principles, okay, about the world. So this all made her unhappy. Why this all made her unhappy? Because she was not able to help him with his lesson, okay? And she never believed in this English school, and she was always distressed. She was always upset because in that particular school they were not teaching about the God or about the scripture, okay? And when she found out she's not able to help her grandson, and in that particular school they're not teaching about the God or scriptures, so she felt disapproval. She was upset, and she didn't say anything to him. She didn't talk anything to him. She just left that room. And after that, it was very difficult for them to talk to each other. It was very difficultly or rarely they used to talk to each other. Now in paragraph 7, the author says, when he went to the university, okay, when he went to the university, he got his own room, his own personal room, right? His own room. And where the friendship between this grandma and grandson has totally broke, okay? And grandmother, without any difficulty, she accepted that my grandson has grown up and now he doesn't need me. So she designed her friendship with her grandson. She always used to sit on her spinning wheel, okay, and she never talked to anyone, and she always busy with her reciting prayers from morning to evening, sunrise to sunset, and only the afternoon time she used to get relaxed, because that is the time where she used to feed the sparrows, okay? So when she sat in the veranda, she used to break the bread into little bits, okay? And then you can see hundreds of little birds coming there and collecting the bread bits, and they used to eat it, okay? That is how she used to spend her afternoon, and all the birds used to sit on her leg, sit everywhere, wherever the birds wanted to sit, okay? And never ever my grandmother have chased the birds, okay? So she gave the freedom to the birds. Wherever they want, they can sit. And it was only half an hour of her day where she used to be very happy. Remaining hours she used to be sad, because she always sit on her wheelchair and talk and just reciting her prayers.